Welcome to a new test and teardown video. It's another oscilloscope. This one, it's a Gould Advance 15 megahertz OS-255. It is a very, very classic layout here. I don't really see any fancy features or anything smart or special. It's just doing exactly what it is supposed to do. I mean, there isn't anything here. I just, this is probably a very, very cheap standard basis hobby starter oscilloscope. I mean, it's also probably like 30 years old or something like that. The classic problem with this series of products from Gould, and that's the way they designed the front plates. As you can see here, it's I think it's not that easy to see, but here it is easy to see. See, this plastic is getting loose, and it's glued with some double sticky tape on the aluminium plates that makes up the front plates. And it is just not the best kind of tape. So what you see people do is they remove all the knobs and, you know, disassemble it completely and then re-glue this plastic, and then it's gonna be all right and super nice and shiny again. I don't know if this works or not. I didn't power it up yet. So be my guest and join the power up party. But before we power it up, let's just double check on the rear panel. It is set for 220. And here's the funny thing. You can adjust plus the 100 or 220 and then plus 20 or not. So that is, if you have 240, then you switch that one. That's pretty funny. Fuse and then the IEC connector. I really like the IEC connector, so that means it cannot be that super, super old intensity, so that's also good to have. And yes, exactly what I said, Gould Advance. So I am ready to power it up, and that is mains on, no idle. Zero watts. Fuse is probably blown. That is not a good sign. Damn it. Yes, the fuse, that was blown. So now I put in a new fuse and then I leave this one on. I turn on my variable supply and then I dial up the voltage real slow to see if there's any crazy power usage. 50 watts, 70 watts, and then, oops, fuse blown again. Damn, damn, damn. There's definitely something wrong in this unit. Okay, so when I cranked up the voltage to 132, it blown the fuse. So no, I don't think this works. So to find the problem inside this oscilloscope, of course, I input a new fuse, and now I'm just cranking up the voltage only until I see like 1 watt of power. Ooh, something is shining. Look at that. A bridge rectifier, that one. It is getting really warm immediately, and I'm just, all the input power is going straight to that rectifier and nothing else at all is hot. It's that easy, and it's super safe to use a thermal camera. So that was real easy. So this is a WO4 diode bridge, so it's good for 400 volts peak, but they got like 210 volts AC, that's RMS. So there probably wasn't enough margin in this design. So what I did here is I changed it to 4007 diodes. So that they're good for a kilovolt. So I think we're not going to have this problem again. It's really funny with this bridge, because when you measure this with a normal diode meter or ohm meter or anything like that, it just seems to be working perfectly fine. But when you up the voltage to like 50 or 60 volts, then it starts to leak a lot and get very, very hot. Actually, enough to take the fuse. So that's really weird. So let's just power up this thing and see. It is, of course, working, because I just had it up and running. I thought I had a picture on this scope, so that's a little bit annoying. Why? Yes, there is a picture, definitely. So, oh, we need to fix the pots. Oy. But anyway, there's definitely a picture on the scope, so I'm super happy about that. And the power consumption is 42 watts. And this voltage goes to a 210 volt regulated high voltage. And also, I really would like to verify that is okay. And I believe the 210 volts is chassis related, so, or relative to that, so no, I can't do that. Ooh, that is a little bit on the high side. And also the ASTIC pot meter here looks like it was very, very warm. So that is why I want to adjust the 210 a little bit down. It should be a regulated power supply. So I don't know, I actually understand why it is a little bit too high. Let's look a little bit on the schematic. I believe this the voltage is probably too high and heating up all this because of the mains input supply is also a little bit too high. Because we got between 200 and I think it's 230 plus minus a little bit. So I should probably adjust this to 240 volt setting and then see how it works out. So that means everything here is gonna run a little bit less stressed. So I think I am more or less done with playing with this unit. I ended up replacing the Darlington transistor in the 210 volt regulated supply. The PNP transistor in that supply was okay. The capacitor is okay. And to trim the output voltage down to 210, I changed the bottom resistor, the R719. So if we look at the schematic, I was also playing a little bit with the schematic like that. And I was writing down all the different voltages to figure out what is going on and how this all works. And I think there was something with the regulation here, and I wasn't too happy about that. And then I put, I think I was 8 kilo parallel with the 18 here to lower the output voltage as well. And this with a new transistor as well, I got now a nice clean high voltage, and that is of course important. Then there's also one of the low voltage regulators using that capacitor, and that was also full of ripple, and ripple is of course not so good in a scope. And other than that, I'm actually done poking around with this. I was looking at the transistor, the ICs. I see Dateco's 79 and I believe that is 80. I think this is the newest one. So I believe this scope is from the 80s. There's actually a little fun thing about the plastic parts here. I mean, look at that. So this is for that switch. That part is exactly the same as that part. So they specially designed that part here so they could flip it, because plastic casting parts and vacuum forming or pressure forming, whatever, they're forming these kind of plastic parts, right? And this is very expensive to do. So it's pretty cool to have a part where you can use the same part. Oh, yeah, see. This is the vertical deflection. And they don't want capacitance. So those wires are lifted up like that. And this is the horizontal amplifier. And this is the output here to the horizontal. Goes to the CRT. So that's brightness and focus. It's a very big single-sided PCB, and I think, yes, this PCB here is also a single-sided PCB. So this is the front end input, and they actually did a little bit of nice detail about here, the input ground. Then we've got some long thin wires here for input from the ground and AC/DC. And we got the first preamp stage that is located up here close to the input. So you will see some dual gate field effect transistors and some matched transistors and stuff like that. And if you see the black resistor down there in the darkness, here we go, that is a integrated resistor, high precision stuff. I think that is a very nice detail to get a very, very good attenuator. And here comes the fun thing is, they're very, very happy about those integrated high precision resistors. So they're actually also using one. Look here, right next to the yellow capacitor. This is the time base. And they're also using integrated high precision. Ay, ay, ay. For the time base, why not make that good as well? And if we look up here again. Ooh, that is a good picture. That's better. So they also use them here. Laser trimmed. And again here. This is for all the high voltage stuff like focus and grids for the CRT. Also integrated high precision resistor. And also for the horizontal deflection. I mean, they really mean a lot of business in with this scope. And it's only a 15 megahertz scope. How about we test how fast this scope is? I think that could be fun. So here is our 1 microsecond pulse at 100 kilohertz repeat. And there is no vertical delay line in this scope. So that means this is how much we are missing. Just a tiny little line of delay. So the trigger is actually quite impressive fast. But we are missing a little bit here before the sweep actually start. So this is the fastest sweep is 500 nanosecond per division. So this 1 microsecond pulse should of course be 2 divisions here, right? So this is obviously how it works. If we go out a little bit more, so this is now 1 microsecond per division. And this is of course why we see now the next pulse. I believe, yes, you see here, if we do like that, then we'll be able to measure the width of our 1 microsecond pulse. So this just proves the time base is indeed very nice and accurate. You see here, it's just exactly on the spot. So that is really good. So this is the maximum frequency of 19 megahertz at about minus 3 dB. And we're using the times 5 magnifier. If I turn off the magnifier, this is how the 19 megahertz looks like. And as you see now, I'm about 90 and 10%, and that is 19 megahertz. If we scroll all the way down, so that is 10 megahertz. So that is, let's go down to 1 megahertz, right? Ooh, nope. So I was actually doing this a little bit wrong. What the heck did I do? I was playing a little bit with the variable sensitivity, 1 megahertz. So that is what fooled me a little bit. See here, there's a little bit of, I need to do a little bit more massage. Oy, 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 oy. So I need to redo that test. Okay, so here we go. After a little bit of massage on that pot and readjusting here. So this is the 0 and 100%, right? So that is 1 megahertz. Let's try again and see what happens. Okay, yeah, here we go. 8, 9, 10. But there's still a little bit to go, right? 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And that is the specifications. Yeah, okay. I would say we are there, right? So yes, it is a 15 megahertz scope, even some, I don't know, 40 years later. Isn't that amazing? So here we go. Definitely it needs a little bit of massage, but it's still working. It could potentially make somebody happy. I think I'm not gonna play so much more with this right now. I will call it a day and say good night. Oh, look at that. This is the crosstalk. How cool is that? Because of that input frequency, this is the crosstalk. Really? So at 15, so if I go down in frequency, yes, definitely. See what happens now? Is the, of course, I cranked up one channel's signal quite a lot. Let's, we need to be fair, right, and be in the same. Okay, so let's do that again. Okay, that was really, really funny. 4 megahertz. And then we go up 10, 11, 12, 15. And then you see all the crosstalk. How? Oh, there's even more. 20 megahertz. How wild is that? What if I, no. That is really cool. I thought I was done. It's just a little bit fun to play with this scope. This is, I just had it. Let's give us a little bit more. At this frequency, it's really dodgy with the switches and all that. So that was 34 megahertz. I thought I had the trigger. Yes, I have it. 33, 4, 5. That's a 35 megahertz. It's actually triggering on. All right, now I will call it a day. Good night and see you tomorrow.